All right, first and foremost, I want to start off by saying, Kohola, Yahweh, Vashem, Yahweh Shai, Vashem, Rakah Kodash. Double honors to the apostles of GMS who rule well and who taught me this truth. And Shalom to you, Sincere Akim, out there listening, learning, and pushing this truth. And Shalom to the few Akwas, the few sincere sisters that are out there listening, learning, and out there listening, and learning also. All right, with that being said, I'm going to jump straight into this video. Lord's willing, it'll be edifying. I'm going to go into Rakah Kodash as usual. This isn't going to be, the Lord's willing, it shouldn't be long. I'm not going to play any videos. I was I've just been meditating on a couple of things. From time to time, I meditate on some things. And a couple of brothers have brought it out. Even the brother Isaria, and the brother in our camp, Isaria, in one of his videos, he mentioned, you know, there's so many things. But it's like the spirit. That's really what's been on my mind, man. I'm gonna go raw as usual, just going to Rakah Kodash. But I don't know. You could just feel something in the air, man. Matter of fact, let me start with this scripture. You could just feel there's something. You know, you could just feel it, man. We in them times, man. We in them latter days. We in them end times, man. You can feel that the doors of mercy are about to close. You can feel that the elect are pretty much damn near sealed already. You can feel that everybody's ready to get, well, the elect anyway, the hopeful elect. You can feel that everybody's serious about this thing, that are serious. You know, you have a few sluggards still, of course, but in general, the men that are, you know, the hopeful elect, we're sealed. And we want to get the fuck out of here, man. And we're doing what we got to do. We're watching the signs, throwing up the prayers, you know, rehearsing the righteous acts. We're doing what we have to do to get the fuck out of here, man. You know, excuse my French, you know, but 2/3, you know, they're going to continue to do what they're going to do, scoff and, you know, be consumed with folly. But the hopeful elect, the men of the Lord, man, you can feel that spirit, you know, turning up, man, you know. As I always say, man, Yahweh Shai is sifting, man. He's sifting the house of Israel, not just within Great Millstone, but within the whole Israel and Yasharal in a whole, man. All the alphabet groups from IUIC, you know, that's why the Gina, the whatever the hell that lady's name that got murked, that certain things are being manifest because Yahweh Shai is sifting, man. He's everything that he said, not one jot, not one tittle is going to pass on the law. Everything is like he said, man, you know. Wars, rumors of wars, you know. Matter of fact, like I said, let me read this first. I don't know how much I'm going to read. I'm just going to Rakah Kodash. Like I said, this video isn't going to be really long, man, Lord's willing. This is Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1. It says, to everything there is a season. And a time to every purpose under the heaven. It says a time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill, a time to heal, a time to break down, a time to build up, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance. A matter of fact, Slaka, let me jump over this. Jump over to this right quick. It says, it's not here, actually. You know, it's not here. I believe it's 2 Ezra 9. It says, measure thou the time diligently within itself. Salak, let me. I believe it's 2 Ezra 9. Salak, you real quick. Bear with me. Khan. Salaki, that's not it. I can't remember what it is, but it says, you know, measure the time diligently within itself, you know. Oh, Khan, I didn't click it. Salaki, my bad. Salaki. Okay, yeah, Khan, my bad. Salaki. Okay, 2 Ezra 9:1. That's what I thought it was. The Wadi Habashim Yashai. Yeah, 2 Ezra 9:1. He answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself. And when thou seest part of the signs pass, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it's the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made. All right. Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquake up, where there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people of the world, then shalt thou well understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning. Okay. For like as all is made in the world hath a beginning and an end, and the end is manifest. The end of what? The end of an era. The end of an age. The end of an empire. The end of Babylon the Great. The end of Esau, Edom's rule. The beginning of Jacob's rule. Okay. Even so, the times also of the highest have plain beginnings and the wonder and wonders and powerful works and an ending and an endings and effects and signs. Okay. That's pretty much the point, though. You know, we know this scripture, but let me go back to Lockie. But that's the point that I wanted to make, man. You know, if you're measuring the time diligently, that's pretty much what this video is about, man. You know, Salakia, you know, I remember because I go back, you know, I was a child back then, but my parents and stuff was in One West. You know, we went through that whole 2000 era. Like I bring out sometimes. And I remember the spirit, the vibration that was in the air with the Y2K when brothers thought the world was going to end. I remember that vibration. But when I sit back and analyze it as an adult looking back, it wasn't the time, man. You know, I know we all know the Lord is going to come as a thief in the night and no man knows the hour. You know, not even the Son, only the Father knows. But certain things like the elders had said had to be manifest. But you could feel that spirit is back. You know, that's same kind of feeling, man, that energy, you know. The Lord is sifting. The Lord is making certain, you know, putting that fire on the men of the Lord. And also, he prophecies is being pushed out at a high level, man. That doctrine, that sound doctrine is being manifest. Like the whole thing with Zabok and the HOI, the going to the gun range. A lot of things have been manifest. The mark of the beast, you know, so things have been. Yasharallah as a whole knows what's up, man. They know the doctrine, man. They may scoff at it. They may, you know, Jacob's trouble. They may scoff at it, and they may say certain things. But it's like Yahabasha, like the elder said, Elder Apostle Hart, the elect gotta pretty much be sealed, and you 2/3 gotta pretty much be scoffed, gotta pretty much be marked, man. Have to be, you know. But anyway, like I said, that's pretty much what this video was about. I'm not even going to continue on those, continuing that, you know. I'm not even going to read no more scripture. Be diligent, you know. Look stuff up for yourself, man. You know, read Second Ezra chapter 9. Read Matthew 24. You know, I was going to read this, but we were like broken records, man. You know, we headed into Jacob's trouble. Okay, we headed into a time like never before. The petrodollar, this fiscal currency, this fiat currency is about to collapse, and all hell is about to break loose, man. Order out of chaos. What? Because the wicked elite, Amalek, chiefly Amalek, the chief house of the red Hebrew Edomites, starting with you bankers, you Rothschilds, you Gettys, you, the oligarchs pretty much, they have an agenda, man. They want to come with that new world order, okay? That cashless society that which ultimately is going to be, at the forefront of it is going to be that chip, that RFID microchip, which is the mark of the beast. You can clearly see, man. You know, wake up the mighty men. You can see, prepare war. All the things that the elders have been saying, you know, and that's pretty much, like I said, what I did was I just typed in YouTube a couple things, and I'll show you. We have to be in them times, man. You know, you can clearly see if you're watching, measuring the time diligently, man. And you can't even keep up. I can't even keep up. This is just a couple things that popped into my mind. You know, we know the yellow vest. This is going on damn near almost a year now. I think 46, 5 days, because today's date is October 4th, 2019, right? And what, 4 days ago, 5 days ago, the 46th weekend of the yellow vest protest, man. Okay. Like the Lord said, uproars of the people, sedition amongst men. You know, this is new. Ecuador, we already know Venezuela is shit. You know, we already know certain countries are shit, but now Ecuador, you know, this is really what prompted me to do the video, because I heard about this, I think it was yesterday or this morning, when I one of the two, you know. Ecuador, 3 hours ago, like I said, today's date is October 4th, 2019. Ecuador declares state of emergency over fuel price protests. Okay? I'm not even going to read none of this. You can look this stuff up yourself. You know, this is recent, man. These are recent events. Just like the Lord said, uproars of the people, man. You know, there's a website you can go and pull up the earthquakes. Earthquakes at an all-time high rate, you know, that weather's out of whack. And not to mention that spirit that's on the prophets, man. The spirit is out here heavy, man. We serious. This ain't like 2000, man. The year 2000, the Y2K thing rolled around. A lot of people didn't really fully understand what they was involved in, man. A lot of the brothers that came into the truth after that, after you damn sluggards, you took your hand from the plow and, you know, you dropped the ball, man. But the men that came, that followed suit, came in at, and we know everything, man. We know about those prophecies. We know about all those excuses you had to fall out the truth. But we keep pushing. Why? Because we are those men. The Lord been sifting, man. And the Lord been refining his men over the years. Okay? So the elect have to be pretty much sealed, man. Throughout the four corners of the earth, man. You know? And like I said, I'm just going raw in the spirit, man. You know? And like I said, when I think back, it wasn't at the rate of, it was heavy in New York and stuff like that. Maybe Philly, up north. But it wasn't, this thing is global, man. Not just Great Millstone, but this truth period. You got ISUPK, you got, you know, Jake Yasharala's woken up, man. You got the confusion of faces. And not to mention the doctrine wasn't, that it was still being, you know, had to be refined, man. We had to get to the whole truth of the matter. Elder Apostle Tahar and Elder Apostle Gabar, you know, that's one of the things that always was on my mind about the confusion of faces, and what the Lord revealed it in due time, you know. So we at that time, man, you know, we at that time where this thing is about to, we ain't got 30 years, you know. You see they about to impeach Trump, slack. Let me, I'm all over the place, man, but it is what it is. But, like, you just can't keep up. It's so obvious, man. The Lord is mustering gathering the armies in the Valley of Jehoshaphat, Yahweh Shaphat over there, in the Gulf over there, in the Middle East, okay? Everything the Lord said, man. And just like the Lord said, people are given a marriage, and as in the days of Noah, they're in Mary, giving them, that's why he's going to catch them as a thief in the night. You can clearly see it. We in them times. We getting close, man. Okay, this is Haiti protest. We've been noticed is going on in Haiti, and I typed in Haiti protest, and the Hong Kong protest is coming up, you know, and they say that's what, 17th straight week, okay, and they're getting more, and the protests over there in Hong Kong are escalating, man. I believe they were actually firing live rounds at the protesters. I saw in one of the videos, man, all right, and then they want to ban the masks now, okay. And we know, like I keep saying, we know it's really the wicked elite, man. Amalek, the Rothschilds, the Vanderbilts, the Kennedys, the DuPonts, you know, the banking families, Amalek, okay, the chief house of Edom. They're the ones that stirring these people up, man. With Antifa and all these, you know, they have their what you call them? I forget the word you call them. I forget, there's a word for those people that go in and stir shit up. I'm drawing a brain fart. But there's a word for, they have people that go in and infiltrate organizations and try to stir people up, man. Okay? We're not ignorant of Satan's devices, man. But we also are measuring the time. We can clearly see everything the Lord said is coming to pass, man. This is what we've been looking for, man. The Lord is about to return, man. I typed in Trump, man. Ace, kingdom divided by Satan, divided against Satan. The kingdom is divided. How can it stand? You know, the patricians and the plebeians are divided, man. The two horns on the lamb, Salakia. I forget exactly, but what the elder was going. I don't even want to think about it right now. But I'm just trying to stay on topic. But yeah, the kingdom is divided, man. Okay, just like the Lord said. And then you got these truthers, they've been exposing. The Lord said their tongues were going to fall upon themselves. Like, you can't keep up with all the prophecies that are being manifest, man. That's what builds your faith. If you measure, that's what should build your faith, man. Okay, we almost out of here. Okay. Iran, Okay? We know that's major prophecy, Persia. Okay? We know that's major prophecy. Okay? You know? It says, Saudi, 3 days ago, Saudi prince warns Iran tensions could lead to unimaginable high oil prices. And that's right there going to cause panic, man. Let gas, the prices of gas skyrocket. That right there could bring in a famine, you know. We in them times, man. This ain't no time to be lollygagging and bullshitting around, man. Now is the time to crack down and get and focus. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Seek him 10 times more, okay? Pray fast, build your faith up. You know, watch the news, watch the brothers, you know. North Korea, that's another big thing, 1 day ago. See, and then tomorrow, something else. Every day, something major is happening, man, okay? You can't keep up, it's impossible. Like the brother said, a couple brothers brought it out, and I've been thinking about that. You can't even keep up, okay? And that's why if you're not doing videos, the Lord ain't the spirit. The Lord ain't dealing with you, man. It's so much going on that if you can't put up three 15 fucking minute videos a week, man, it's so much. What are you really doing with your time? You know? You're going to get caught off guard with the 2/3, man. If you ain't doing the videos, help build your faith also, man. Okay? And if you're not doing the videos, that means you're not watching. And if you're not watching, he's going to cut you off guard also. Okay? All right? Anyway, North Korea, as you can see, they tested more missiles. And Trump was pissed, man. You know? Because they was talking about peace and safety. And we know when they say peace and safety, sudden destruction shall come upon them as a woman in travail. And then, and of course, we got to go back to the... I'm going to end it off with the RFID microchip, man, which is the mark of the beast. Okay? It's obvious, man. You know, you just read some of these. All I typed in was RFID chip. You can clearly see this is the wave. This is what these 5G towers going up. You know, everything is going cashless. Everything is going digital, man. Okay. These aren't even half of these videos aren't even great millstone videos, man. These are just regular people, regular Joes that are telling you this, man. Okay, this is the wave. It's been the wave. Okay, so like I said, the elect pretty much got to be sealed, man. Just like the elder said, and like this pretty much was an exhortation. You know, we know the scriptures already, man. You should know them. Okay, hey, this will just keep pushing, man. Keep watching. Keep being diligent. Any day now, man. You could wake up, like I said, tomorrow, and all hell is breaking loose, you know, which I doubt that's going to happen. But, you know, you want to hasten the day, man. You want to hasten the day. All right. You want to be found doing the work when the Lord returns, man. All right. You don't want to be found with your hands in your pocket, you know, just watching. Okay. Anyway, with that being said, Lord's willing is edifying. Like I always say, man, keep pushing. We almost out of here. Shalom.